Yo, what it do, baby? What it do, YouTube? Hopefully everybody's having an amazing day or night. Hopefully everybody's enjoying season 3. I haven't even tried out Warzone yet. I'm trying to level up this PPSH. I'm going to be playing Warzone tonight, but I'm doing a best settings for both Warzone and for Cold War. So if you're watching this one, go check out my Warzone one and obviously and check that out if you play Warzone, if you play both. Let me know, man. But I'm going to share my settings with you guys, what I run, what I feel is best for me, especially in public matches. I don't play a lot of competitive at all. So I know things could change in that, you know, that scene. But I don't play that. I play public matches. I like to rush. I like to, you know, snap on people, all that good stuff. So let's take a look at these settings, man. And you guys can take whatever you'd like to implement it into yours. So just let me know, man, what you guys find helpful. So we're going to start out with the horizontal stick sensitivity and the vertical. I have a 10 for both. Okay, for the ADS stick sensitivity, low zoom. Okay, this is very, very crucial right here. This is the most important part. I have it at a 0.9. Okay, what I had on Black Ops 4, I believe, and then Modern Warfare, my sensitivity was higher, so I lowered my low zoom sensitivity. So when you aim in, it's slower, side to side. Okay, if that's up, it's like when you aim it, it's really quick side to side, but I counter it, so I'm able to snap on them back and forth, but when I aim in, it's slow, so it brings it back down. It's like a perfect feeling. So I may jump this up to even a 12 or 13 sensitivity and go down to a 0.8 with this. So that's something that I may try here in the near future, but this is very crucial and I do love this. Okay, for the ADS stick sensitivity, high zoom, which is a sniper, I like to move quicker because obviously if you have a low one for this, it's really slow when you're aiming down like a sniper scope. So I think raising that a little bit to 1.1, maybe even more. I'm not a sniper, so I don't use it very often, but it's helpful. So I recommend doing that a lot. Or I recommend doing that for sure. Button layout, stick and move. I always use stick and move. I do have a scuff as well. Okay, I use the right stick to jump, and I use my paddles to armor up in Warzone and do all that good stuff, to slide, to melee. That's what I use my paddles for on my scuff. Okay, but stick and move, I absolutely fell in love with it back in Modern Warfare, but a little bit before Modern Warfare. But I just fell in love with it, never went back, man. I'm so glad I went to it. You know, it's awesome. It's one of those things when you go back or you try it, you don't want to go back from it. Then I have nothing. This is default. Invert is disabled. Aim response curve type is standard. I've never changed any of these aim response or stuff like that. Controller vibration, turn it off now. If you guys have it on, man, it actually affects the way you aim. Do pros have it on? No, they don't. Okay, there's a reason for that. They don't want something shaking in their hand while they're in a gunfight. You guys don't think it matters, but it truly does. So if you want to hit one or two more shots, that could be crucial, especially in a game like Call of Duty or FPS. Turn that off. Okay, I really recommend that. It's very important. Target aim assist, enabled, just regular aim assist enabled, obviously. Target aim assist mode, standard, haven't changed that. ADS aim assist is enabled. Airborne mantle, automatic. Then a lot of these are the same. You hold to ADS, steady aim behavior, hold, armor, apply one, aim base. Okay, nothing crazy about those. Okay, stick layout, default, ADS stick swap, disable. Okay, intent, I guess these are all just put on there right away. I've never touched these. I've never changed them before. So I'm just going to go through these really quick. I'm not worried about any of these. Auto sprints, all disabled, but I heard that is good if you get used to it. So you could try that out. Okay. Tap to reload. So my reload behavior, I tap it to reload. Tap it to reload, okay? Graphics, nothing crazy about this. My color blind right here. As you can see, it's Tritonopia. I think that's how you pronounce it. I do recommend this. It makes a vibrance of the game. Okay, it makes it very vibrant. It makes it look good. Okay, I do like that a lot. And my brightness is at 47, I believe. Yes, 47 brightness. I lowered my brightness a little bit. And then I also have the saturation on my monitor turned up. And I changed some of the hue and stuff on my Elgato to make my gameplay look really good. And field of view, very, very important as well. I have it maxed out at 120. I would think anywhere between 110 to 120 is perfect. So just whatever you feel good at, whatever your personal preference is for that, okay? Motion blur is disabled 100%. I don't want that on there. Don't use it. It'll affect your gameplay, in my opinion. Right here, master volume's at a 50. I don't know why I have it at 50. I don't think I've ever touched it. And then everything else, music is a 0. I don't like hearing the music in the background. High boost, audio preset. Hit markers, you want hit markers, that helps with accuracy. One thing you could do, if you turn that off, it's very helpful to with your accuracy by playing with it off and then turning it back on and adjusting to that. If you can't hear them, that means you really have to focus on hitting them and right on your, you know, your iron sights or optic. Then when you put it back on, then you feel like you don't miss ever. So that's one tip right there I just gave you guys. I know that I've done a lot. Down here, I haven't changed any of this, so I'm not really too worried about it. Interface, nothing crazy. I haven't changed any of this either, so I wouldn't even touch that. If you find something that's helpful for you, go ahead and change it, but I haven't changed any of it. Keyboard, mouse, I'm on a controller, obviously, and this right here has nothing to do with anything at all. So basically, the first two pages are the most important. I would say changing the ADS stick sensitivity, the low zoom down, and raise your sensitivity up, especially in public matches. And then I would also say the graphics with the colorblind settings, which are very, very good, and it makes the game look very colorful and very vibrant. So I do recommend those. So that's all I have for you guys today. Hopefully you guys enjoy these settings. Like I said, if you take one or two of these and implement it to yours, let me know, man. Let me know if it helps you guys. If not, hey, man, that's fine. Yeah, everybody has their personal preference, but hopefully everybody's enjoy season three. I'm going to be uploading tons of content, guys. If you do enjoy it, make sure to hit the subscribe button down below, and don't forget to drop a like, man. Have a great day, everybody. I'll see you guys in the next one. Peace.